A really great way to increase interest and engagement on your social media videos is to add a little intrigue or incorporate a reveal of some kind. This is especially useful for videos or even adverts where you want to showcase features or text alongside an image or a video. So today we're going to use a simple but really versatile card animation to do just that, and we're going to create it in Canva. We're going to start with a blank mobile video design in Canva for this demo. But this effect can work in really any size or layout, and I'll show you a couple of examples of just how versatile it is later on in this tutorial. For this example, I'm going to create a reel to showcase some testimonials. The first thing we're going to do is to add a title page. Now, if you wanted to use an existing Canva template as a starting point for the title page, you can just go to the Design menu and then Templates, and search or browse until you find one that works for you. We're going to create one from scratch and keep it really simple. I'm just going to add in a text box on a blank page, and I'm going to add in my copy. And then I'm just going to format it using my brand fonts and colors, which of course I can easily select because I've set up my brand kit in Canva. Then again, I'm going to go to Elements and Frames, and I'm going to add two of these pill-shaped image frames. Now, you can add anything into these frames, really, but using the images you're going to use later in the video is a really good way of teasing a little about what's coming. For this layout, I want the frames to kind of be spaced between the words. So I'm just going to create that layout by changing some text spacing in the paragraph and then resizing and placing those pill frames where I want them with the images in. Then I'm going to add some simple animation. For this, I want it to be really subtle, so I'm going to use the animation called Tectonic in Canva. And I'm going to have the text moving in from one direction and the frames from the other. So it's really simple, but it creates a really nice effect and still has some movement. And of course, to ensure I've got some branding going on, I'm going to drop my logo in too. And I'm going to animate that just with a simple rotate animation. Now let's move on to the card reveals. We're basically going to create and going to need two things for each slide: the image frame and the text or content group. For the image frame on a blank slide, I am just going to add in a simple frame with rounded corners. And then I'm going to drag in the image that I'm using for my first testimonial. That makes up our first card. Then I'm going to add in my text card or content. I'm going to start with a simple white rectangle, and I'm going to match the corner rounding to the image frame. Obviously, the content on this card can be anything that you want, anything that suits your purpose. For these testimonials, I'm going to add in a name and a title, and then I'm going to add in the actual quote or testimonial with some quote marks. And here I'm just using placeholder text. I'm keeping it nice and simple text-wise, and most importantly, making sure that it's easy to read. Then I'm going to group those text boxes with the rectangle, so it acts as one element and becomes one card that we're going to animate. Now for the first slide that these appear on, I'm going to have the two cards aligned vertically and horizontally so that one covers the other. Because it's a testimonial, I'm going to have the text card on the front, but you can obviously choose to have the image on the front or on top if that works for you. I'm also going to add a little shadow, a rectangle shadow element behind the text card. Now obviously you don't have to do this, but I think it adds a little depth, which is nice in any of these designs. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to duplicate that entire page twice. For the first new page that I've just duplicated, I'm going to rearrange and resize those two cards to show the reveal. So for mine, I'm going to make the text card bigger, which is a group, and I'm going to make the image frame smaller. And I'm then going to have them sort of fanned out a little so that the image reveals from behind the text card. I'm also going to move the shadow behind the text card and move it out a little further so it creates the illusion that the card moves towards the viewer a little. For the second page we duplicated, we're going to leave it just the same, so that after we've had that reveal page, everything goes back to how it was on the first content page with the two cards aligned. Then I'm just going to add a blank page to kind of finish this section. Now that those are all in, let's add the movement. So for the transition from our title slide to the first content slide where the cards are overlapped, I'm going to use the flow transition. And that way people will get a sneaky little glimpse of the image as the transition happens and the content moves in from the right. Then between that slide and the slide with the open or fanned out content, I'm going to use our good old match and move transition, which will create the animation effect of those cards moving and changing size. And then, making them return to their stacked view, I'm going to use the same match and move transition between those two slides. From this page to the blank page, I'm going to use the flow animation again, but I'm going to make sure that it's in the opposite direction so the cards move off to the left. Now we just want to check on and refine the timings. We want the first stacked slide to be fairly brief, and then the opened version we want long enough to allow people to read the content and to enjoy and take in the image. And then for the final closed version, on that page we want it to just be very brief, and we also want the blank slide very brief because it just creates a clear break between sections. It doesn't need to be very long. Now I'm just going to copy and paste all of these content slides so that we essentially have a duplicate, almost a template to work with to create further sections like this. So for this new section where I've duplicated all these slides, we can just go through and adjust the content. We can copy and paste our new text, and we can change the image. Now, to replace the image that's in frames that are behind the text, if you have them that way, remember you can just use your position and then layers tool to move that image frame to the front, drop in your image, and then move it to the back again. Another really important thing to remember is that when we use the match and move transition, it only works if the content from one page to the next is exactly the same. So for example, here on the second testimonial, where we're using the photo of this hideously unattractive man, if we change the text on one slide only, we'll lose the animation effect and it will be replaced with just a standard fade. You can see that as I drag the playhead here. Now that's not bad, but it doesn't work quite as well and it's not the effect we want. Next, we can just follow the same process of copying and pasting that whole section and replacing content as many times as works for us or as we need for this particular showcase. Honestly, this simple animation is so useful and it can be used for all sorts of things. You can use it for product reveals or to showcase product features, or to show real estate listings, or even beauty product ingredients. Honestly, the list is endless. And before I show you a few examples that I created using the same process that we just followed, if you are enjoying this tutorial and you find it helpful, I would love to invite you to join my weekly design digest called Meaningful Creations. Meaningful Creations is a newsletter that goes out every week with new tutorials and resources and inspiration for online business owners and creators who want to uplevel their Canva and design skills, and also who want to learn from examples and insights from other meaningful creators that I showcase. And I won't lie, my cats make a regular appearance. You can just visit the address that's on the screen right now, or just click on the link in the description and sign up for free. Plus, I have some really super cool new free resources that I'm working on, and you'll want to be on the list to be the first to know when those launch. Okay, so back to our design. Now, as I mentioned, this is a really versatile template that we can create and can be used in a whole range of ways. So here are a few really quick examples that I created using this exact same process that we've just been through. That's it, folks. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you for being here and for being so damn lovely. Don't forget to sign up for my newsletter and have a fabulous week.